Hey viewers, in case you haven't noticed, well, I cleaned off my desk in my room here, but that's not the important thing. We are going to check out Splitface. You're probably wondering, oh wait, you already did a Splitface review. No, that's not what you're wondering, that's what you're thinking. You're thinking, wait, Pip. You already did a Splitface review. Why are you doing another one? Well, the last one wasn't very good. So I'm just going to improve on this one. I'm going to improve on this one, like give some more information, you know, that kind of stuff. I did happen to put his ball back in his bag, but that's not what I'm going to show you right now. So I'm just going to give some more information. This, which I did not show in the previous review of Splitface. So I forgot to mention, most of the villains in this series, Breakout Wave 1 and 2, Wave 1 and Wave 2, Wave 1 was December 2011, Wave 2 is now, basically, Wave 2, Summer 2012, July, August, you know what I mean. Anyway, so, once again, I will tell you, show you his shredding claw. Once again, I will show you his insecticide slash precision laser. Precision laser. This is the insecticide gun, and this is the precision laser, in case you were wondering. A lot of villains have their head forward like this. It makes them, like, kind of look like they're hunching. At the same time, it makes them look pretty villainous. But then again, they are villains. Now, you're probably wondering, wait, they're covering his backup? Why don't they cover everyone else's backup? Well, you see, he's got this tube. That's usually the only reason why they cover the character's backup with a footpiece. Well, for Breeze, she doesn't have a tube connecting to her back. And she's got a footpiece on her back. I'm not going to show you right now, especially since that actually belongs to my sister, not to me. Of course, yeah, never mind. As I was saying, actually, there's not much else to point out here. This dual-plated armor, same exact thing that Surge has, only this, it goes in the other direction. If you don't know what I'm saying, let me show you. What I meant is, this points the other way, like that, for Surge. I'm not gonna put it on like that, I'm just gonna put it back on the way it's supposed to be. Anyway, for his shredding claw, you see this armor piece? Looks familiar? It was first introduced with the Fire villains. Fire Lord and Drilldozer both have this armor piece. When I first got Splitface back in, I don't know, February? April? I don't even remember when I got him, just earlier in 2012. But he's got one on his leg and his shredding claw. And, of course, these actually aren't new. A lot of characters are using these nowadays. Especially the newer ones. Stringer has some unique shoulder armor pieces, which are actually Sonic speakers, as they're called, Stringer, one of the new summer 2012 sets that finally got released, fully released. What's going on? Oh, okay, still recording. Okay, we're good. Now, as I was saying, like, the back is covered simply because there's a tube. Ryu's doesn't have a tube, and hers is covered as well. Now, Black Phantom, yes, he's got tubes going both ways, but he's got his own unique back structure. He doesn't use a foot piece. I put everyone's balls in their boxes and bags already. As you can see here, I've also got some Transformers, as you may already know that. But anyway, that's not what we're doing here. Anyway, Splitface, good figure. Hope you get him. Well, it's your opinion, not mine, but anyway, he's a good figure, so if you like him, I recommend getting him. And I'll see you guys later. I don't know if I'll get... I'm hoping to get Stringer and Voltix, and so I'll be doing reviews for them pretty soon. Bye, guys.